here. You might want to pour it down in front of your mouth.
It's like it's not working. It's like it's picking up a laptop mic or something. I don't know. I got her cranked up to 180%. I still can't hear.
I can hear. Kind of body. Did you hear that?
Sounds like she's talking in the other room where you're at. You know what I mean?
It might be just that headset. That's the new headset.
I got her cranked up all the way.
Do you want me to yell? Does that help any?
I yell
all by myself down here.
You can if you want.
I hear an echo. Are you in the toilet? All right, that'll work.
I'm sorry.
No, it's all good.
I'm just trying to find a spot that's close to my Wi-Fi thing, because if not, upstairs I can't get sick.
You're good.
Okay.
All right, everybody ready?
Yeah.
All right. You guys were at the tavern, for those who were here last time. You guys had just defeated the leader of the group. His name was Deadeye. He was a captain. He came in raising hell. He's looking for the person you guys are looking for, and you guys are trying to get information from. And once you guys defeated Deadeye and his cronies, she basically told you Deadeye's got a ship down on the dock. Basically, it's free reign now since you guys killed him. And she let you know that the dead three, they're seen hanging out at the bathhouse. And you guys basically have two courses of actions you can go through right now. One, you can go down to the bathhouse and try to find the dead three. Or you can go to the docks and see about taking on what's left of Deadeye's crew and possibly have your own ship. And that's kind of where we left off.
Yeah, actually, Ronnie, we decided to go to the deck and claim that ship.
Okay.
Yeah, so as I remember, we decided to go do that.
Right after the brawl, you guys come to conclusion. Bodar decided he's going to go to the bar and have a few drinks, and he told you he's going to catch up to you later. And then he's going to hang out at the bar. And then you are greeted by two females. One you know, which is the rogue. She's like, hey, did I miss all the action? Kind of thing. So she's back in the picture. And then there's another one. And Tabitha, I'll let you introduce yourself.
Okay. I don't know what I'm doing. Just telling you what my character is. It's all still new to me because I just created a new one.
Tell us about your character, what your character is, what you're doing.
I'm having a real hard time. I mean, you're really low.
Yeah, same here.
Give me a stick.
Hey, Chris, did you test out her microphone? I'm wondering, is she on a laptop?
Yeah, she's on a laptop. I got her headset one. I let her borrow one of the new headsets.
I'm wondering if the headset is not default mic. The mic be set to something else, because I can barely hear her.
Yeah, that's true. So, tab on the bottom of your
tab. It says default mic.
default on both of them. Click on your audio button on the bottom of your screen on your taskbar. You click it once. And what does it say right there? Does it say?
It's that your bombs, the evolved
one. Okay, click that and turn the volume all the way up.
96.
And you have your little mic pulled down from your ear, from your mouth, right?
Yes.
It might be a bad headset. Or one that's cutting in and out.
Does she have to the microphone on her laptop? Just use that one. It might even be better than what she's got now.
Try and disconnect your headphones.
Louder.
Yeah, it's louder. Might be your sound driver.
Do what?
Maybe I should sit this one out so we figure out what's going on with my laptop.
You're coming in better now.
You can hear me the whole time. I don't know if anybody else can hear me. I can't hear anything now other than you.
I can hear.
It's coming in better for me.
It's louder for sure, but it's just breaking up. Breaking up my head.
Yeah, it's breaking up too. Does she have a reception problem?
I don't know. I'm literally by my thing. I'll just log out and we'll figure it out at another time. Sorry, guys.
You can use your phone.
I don't even know how to log in on my phone. And I'm holding you guys up. It's fine. It's fine. It's not a big deal. Y'all go ahead.
I can hear you right now if you're just close.
We can hear you.
I don't know why it's breaking up. I was literally sitting right next to where Chris hooked up the Wi-Fi. So I don't know what you could do.
Yeah, that is definitely better.
Yeah, you're a lot better now.
You're fine.
It's supposed to be done. It's got me frustrated now.
Okay. So I guess I'm telling you guys about my character.
Yep.
So my name is Paula, and I'm a Mountain Dwarf Barbarian. I haven't really had much time to figure out what my backstory was going to be, I'll be honest with you.
No, you're good.
What else do I need to tell you guys? Because it's weird not being in person. I don't know what to do. You know I do better in person.
Is she a nose picker?
Is she a nose picker? She probably does that. She probably picks her nose, probably picks her butt. Whatever she wants to do, she don't care.
All right.
You know how
we're good now. We're good. We got it all.
She does it all. Why not?
All right. So
I'm neutral. I will tell you guys that I'm very neutral. Okay. So.
All right. So you come into the fold by you're sitting in the bar, the tavern. These guys just took out Deadeye, which is a very well known bad pirate, and so I'll let you go from there. Let you join the party kind of thing.
So can you explain to me one more time, you guys, who Deadeye, like, he was a pirate, was he? So he's the bad guy, right?
Yeah.
Obviously.
He just kind of came in the room and interrupted what was going on, and these guys took him out.
Okay, so has anybody checked his body and seen if there's any loot or anything on him?
Yep, that's all been done.
Okay, so what did everybody get? Did anybody get anything?
I guess they got a few things. I don't remember who got what.
Yeah, we got a few things, not too much, just some weapons, a little bit of gold and stuff, and then we, after that was over, we went down the bar, and we decided we're going to start heading down to the dock, and that's where we ran into Kayla, and, Elwick, and now we're going to head down to the docks.
Alright.
Do you guys want to join you? I need a party, somebody. I don't want to be out here by myself.
Yeah. Come on down.
Okay, so what's everybody want to do?
I think we're going to take the boat.
Yeah, let's go claim that boat.
All right, so you guys go down the docks. You find the boat. You definitely find the boat. It's named the Uncivil Serpent. And it's sitting there, and you see five guys on deck. And they're like standing around, looking like they're waiting for something.
I think I'm gonna walk up to him, and I think that's probably not my character to do, but I'm gonna have to walk up to him and tell him that we're claiming the boat.
Straightforward approach.
All right, you go do that. I got your back. I'll stay behind and grab my short bow in case if something goes wrong.
Sounds good.
Cool.
Can I click what everybody is so I kind of have an idea?
Can you what?
What everybody is. Like, I know what Chris is. I see his. Like, what everybody's character is. So I kind of have an idea of who's what.
First, you want to introduce yourself?
I'm a rogue fighter. I'm not sure. Can't remember what everybody else was.
Yeah, I am a druid, the wolf elf, the wood elf.
Okay.
I mean, I'm a rogue assassin.
I'm a rogue gnome.
I gotta turn her up. I'm gonna figure out. Hold on just a second, I cannot.
Yeah, right click on her icon. There's a volume button.
Maybe I can hear her now. Can you repeat that again, girl? I'm sorry.
I'm a rogue gnome.
Okay, I got you. Oh, so most of us are all little people. Okay, that's better. Good. Okay. Thank you. I just kind of wanted to know what everybody was, so that helps me to know what to do.
Okay.
Okay. So, Chris, you're going to the boat, right?
Yeah, I would, honestly, being my character's more of a sneaky and a stealthy kind of thing, so it's
right.
Out of north, my character, so you're a barbarian, so I would imagine you may want to be the one to go up to him and be the upfront.
Well, I was going to ask you that if you wanted me to go with you. So that way...
I'll let you go up front, do the talking, and I'm kind of going to go rotate stealthily around this side of these guys to kind of get behind them.
Okay, so you want me to go tell him we're taking the boat?
Pretty much.
Okay, so we're going to do that. But I'll go first and tell him we're taking the boat. Sound good?
Yep. I'm gonna try and stealthy go around behind them.
Behind who?
The five guys.
Okay, so they're on the boat. You're on deck, so you're gonna go up to the boat?
Yeah, Teb's gonna go confront them first, and while she's confronting them and attacking them, I'm gonna try and slip behind them. Or is there a way I can get around them from a different boat?
No, not really. I mean, they're on a ship. You know, they're high up.
Well.
Okay, so.
Roll your stealth check.
And I'll go ahead and go up on the boat and talk to them.
You want to roll a stealth check?
Yes.
Sounds good.
Cool. So I walk up to the boat. I get on the boat. I go up to, is there a ringleader?
You guys killed the ringleader.
Okay, so I just talk to them in general. So yep. I say, hey, guys, just want to let you know we need this boat. So we're going to commandeer it, and you can kind of go with us or not.
Cool. Who's all behind you?
Chris, are you behind me?
Yeah, I explained what I was going to do, right?
Roll me a stealth check. If you're going to go up stealthily, if they don't see you,
you better sneak.
They're just going to see Furs and Amanda's character.
Stealth.
See what I'm saying?
Yep.
All right. Okay, I rolled a 15 on that, so I do not see you. So all I see is Kayla, Furs, and Alleywick. Alleywick, are you going stealth or are you guys staying invisible? What are you guys doing?
Okay, so
I think it will be better. I think it was better if we show up ourselves so they kind of get scared and see they might be just agree to leave the boat without any fight.
Right.
All right.
Then I'll join. They could go with us.
Okay, so you guys are going with her? All right. Kayla, roll me a, I guess, either intimidation or persuasion.
I'm taking 2 seconds. Gotta go back to my thing. Should I do intimidation, you think, or persuasion? Probably.
That's up to you. If you're trying to commandeer the boat peacefully, maybe persuasion?
I would say persuasion, but that, I have like a plus one on that, so hold on. So I will, so I roll a d20 plus, what was my number again? I don't remember, it's been a while. Whatever my...
What
plus is my fire, plus one.
Okay, that was it, okay. So do I just hit the button after I have that typed in?
Yeah.
Is that right?
Yep.
All right,
okay, 12.
Yeah. Right. Next time I'll type my name, sorry.
No, you're fine.
Sorry, you guys. I'm learning again on this. I don't know how to do it.
You're
on
fine. Quit saying sorry, damn it.
I'm going to say sorry, Rodney. You know who I am, bro. I don't know the other people, so I'm apologizing.
Let's see. I think I'm going to try to counter that. Let me see if he's persuaded or not. He's got a plus zero, so let's try D20, six. Yeah, he's on board. But his buddy walks up and says, "Hey, you gonna pay us? Well, you're gonna need a rigging crew."
Well, over here, I'm not real sure, people, what we have because I'm new to the game here. So do we have money to pay them? What do y'all want to do?
We got the money, but do we want to spend on them?
What if we tell them we'll let them go with us and wherever we get to?
Here's the deal. You guys are going to need a crew to sail your ship. You're going to need more than just you guys. So you guys are going to need somebody. And they're already agreeing to go with you. You might want to figure out some sort of a wage.
Out pay them.
Yeah.
I mean, it depends on what they're wanting. So what do you guys think? You want to ask them like what they're looking for, how much they're asking for, or you want to just offer them something? I don't know how much y'all have, so.
Ask and negotiate.
Huh?
Ask and then negotiate.
Oh my god. Okay. All right. So I ask him, I said, well, listen, I understand we definitely are going to need some help. We'd really appreciate it. So y'all are going. We don't mind paying y'all something, but what are you thinking? Like, how much are you thinking here?
He basically tells you that they're getting one gold piece a week each. Okay. They were considering a mutiny. They would like at least 2 gold pieces a week. And there's 5 guys.
Me,
So that there's five guys, so that's going to be 10 gold pieces a week out of your guys' inventory.
And how long do you think it's going to take us to get to where we need to be?
I don't think we're going anywhere right now.
This is your ship. This is yours, regardless if you're going anywhere or not. They're on the payroll.
So here's what I'm going to say, guys. Like, if y'all give me a minute, let me talk to my other people with me, and we'll get back with you, and we'll kind of figure out what we're going to do. So you're thinking y'all probably want at least 2 gold pieces a week, a piece.
Yep, for the 5 of us, it'd be 10 gold pieces.
Okay. So I turn and I talk to my crew, like, what do you guys, bring them over to the side, say, what do you guys think we should do? Should we pay them the 2, or should we offer 1.5? What should we do?
We should offer them 1.
I don't think 1's going to work. I think they're going
to have to get paid 1 because they were planning a mutiny. So what if we offer them like 1.5? Maybe give them the 2. What kind of gold do y'all got? I don't know.
I'll make a bunch of money last time.
I said just pay them the 2 gold, considering y'all just made 12 grand off of selling the last ship.
See, that's what I'm asking y'all. I don't know what we have. And I'm honestly talking. So,
pay them the 2, and they can stay on the boat and secure the boat while we're out and about.
Yeah, because otherwise, it's going to show up, you know, missing.
Somebody has to hijack the boat while we're gone.
Okay, so when they turn back and say, look, guys, like, we're all in agreement with this, right?
Yep.
Okay, so we agree. We'll pay you the 2 pieces per week per person. Does that sound good to y'all?
Yep.
Okay. So I just tell the guys that, Rodney, like, I let them know that we're willing to pay them the 2.
There's your boat.
I was thinking of that. Can we have something a little bit more 3D?
3D?
Yes, sir.
No, that's about all you're going to get for 2 gold pieces.
If I do 3 gold pieces, can I get 3D?
No, sorry.
If I do 4... Can I get my 3D animation?
Oh, I see it. Never mind.
Moving on.
So everybody take 2 gold pieces out of your inventory.
I didn't have any, so somebody's got to cover me.
Yeah, well, I can.
You guys don't have a community pot?
Huh?
You guys don't have a community pot?
Are y'all all keeping up with your own, or are y'all putting it all together? I don't know. I'm used to putting everything in 1 pot.
Yeah, I thought there was a community pot going on. Isn't that what Damien was doing?
Oh, I don't know what he was doing. I had stuff that I've had on mine. My character had whatever he had.
Okay, does anybody have a
We'll worry about that later. Damien's got it.
Yeah, we'll get Damien.
He's not here.
Yeah.
Okay. So we'll just keep up with it this game and then check with him. Is that okay?
Yep.
Okay.
All right. So you guys go back to talk to Chicky Poo.
Okay.
Tarina. And she tells you, you know, several blocks northeast of here is a public bathhouse with a walled garden of frolicking nymphs. Carved into its front gates. This is what she told you guys last week. I'm just repeating it. She said that the followers of the dead 3 have been seen coming and going from these bathhouses. And she says, I have been told that there's a secret door inside that leads to a dungeon. From what I understand, that's where the killers are hiding.
Can you post that map again, please, sir?
Post what?
The map again.
The map? What map?
Yes. The map of the city since we started in a new chat.
All right, so you want City of Boulder's Gate?
I would like to see that.
And if you got the other map that shows the other cities?
Bear with me while I frolicking for a map. There you go, sir.
And that map, you can zoom in on that map. It's a pretty cool map. I'd click on it and zoom in.
Okay.
if you wish.
And that's kind of cool. Okay.
So we're on the bottom, right?
Are we at the low lantern area? Is that where we're at?
Somewhere in there.
Rodney?
Yes.
Where are we at, Dolph?
That's the city. You're in the city.
Okay. Well, I was just asking where we're at on the outskirts, like wherever by the boat. Where are we at now? We're on the right side, the left side.
You guys are in the Elf Song Tavern.
Elf Song Tavern, okay. Sometimes I can't hear because it cuts out on my end. It's my fault. Okay. All right.
I'm trying to find another map for you.
Did you find it?
Yeah, I just got to cut it. Give me a second here. There you go.
Sweet.
All right. So, what are you guys gonna do?
So we go to the bathhouse. Bathhouse.
I say I agree. So we can figure out how to get down that, like, dungeon or cavern or whatever. What do you guys think?
All right, to the bathhouse. Not to the bat house, but to the bathhouse. All right. You guys make it your way to the bathhouse. When you get closer to it, you see the bathhouse is a one-story stuccoed building, stained glass windows and a clay roof tiles. 10 feet tall walls enclose a large courtyard outside of the southeast corner of the building. The closed wooden doors to the courtyard are engraved with images of smiling nymphs dancing and frolicking in the water. So what do?
Let's burn down. It's wood. Right?
Burn down the building?
No, burn down the gate.
is the gate locked?
I don't know, is it?
We open the gate? Okay, I'm gonna go up and check the gate to see if it opens.
Okay. Gate opens. So hey, it's role-playing, man.
Does anybody
can we see what's behind the door?
Yep. Somebody's got to play the door, right?
Right. All right. So I was wondering, can anybody else tell if there's anything bad? What is that? Like divine sense or not divine sense, but what is it they use normally, Rodney? Like what's it called? Like somebody that would have like traps can check for traps. Is that you?
So you want to check a little late on that.
Huh?
A little late on that.
I guess you're right, but... Okay, so who wants to go through first, then?
I guess I'll go ahead and walk in, and I'm going to walk towards bathhouse.
When you guys get in there, you're looking at this area. Let me get this up. Maybe.
Can you guys hear my kids yelling upstairs, or is it just me? I just want to make sure y'all ain't hearing them.
Just you.
They're yelling at video games.
What the hell? Alright, screw it. I'm just going to put the whole thing in there. Right now, you guys see this. You guys are entering D1. So anything outside of D1, you do not really see. Okay?
That's the yard, front yard, basically.
This is an L-shaped courtyard. Features a trim lawn and nicely manicured shrubbery. The yard is decorated with white marble benches, stone fountains, and each in the form of smiling nymphs tipping a jug that spills water into a circular stone basin.
I'm going to check the fountains, see if I see anything, or check the whole courtyard, look around the courtyard, see if I can find anything. Anything out of ordinary, anything kind of...
I can help you.
My eye.
No, you don't see anything. Give me a perception check.
Nothing. I got an 8.
Okay. Yeah, nothing. You don't see anything. Everything looks hunky-dory. No issues.
Do you have a moral perception you want us to check, or is it just there's nothing, Robbie?
That's up to you.
What do you want to do, Chris?
I can check if you want.
Let me check.
Whoever's high on perception.
That name, I cannot. Every time I look at it, Chris, seriously.
I just thought of it on the fly.
His middle name is 420.
My good, only 9.
No. Nope.
I can do it. Give me a second. You got 9. Okay. I don't think there's gonna be anything there.
Okay.
Why isn't
that scrolling down?
Yeah.
Yeah.
17.
Look at Amanda go. Whatever,
we finally get some.
Amanda, you think you might have caught something in the corner of your eye, but when you went to look, it was gone.
What?
Yep. I know it.
Oh, yeah. Can I follow in the direction of what I saw?
You saw off the left hand of your corner of your eye.
It was a firefly.
Could be.
I'm gonna go check that front door for any kind of. Is this the front door right here? You got windows.
Yep, that is a front door.
I'm gonna peek in one of those windows, see if I see anything in there.
Okay. When you look in there, you see. Looks like a couple humanoids are in there.
Are they talking? Are they sitting in the water? What's going on?
What water?
I'm assuming those were. Pools inside of D2.
Hold on.
Yeah, jacuzzi.
Yeah.
You see 3 people in there, 3 humanoids. They appeared to be, you're not quite sure.
What are they doing? They're just talking.
Just kind of standing there talking. Okay. You see nearby, it looks like to be some sort of a pool, maybe.
Okay. Sweet. After bath. That's
should, bad. Should we just go ask them what they're doing and what?
Yeah, let's check the front door. I'm gonna check for traps though, real quick.
Okay.
What do I need to throw for that? Perception, stealth, not stealth. Perception, probably.
What are you checking for? What traps?
Traps.
No, yeah. That's dex.
Okay, same thing. Still.
Yep. You want to check your dex.
20 plus 4. Jeez, man. I'm not seeing anything. I'm just going to go ahead and open the door.
Okay. Door opens up fine, no problem. Inside, you see a couple guys seem to be in a bath.
Okay.
Not together, of course. This is a bathhouse, after all.
Well, then how do you know they're not together?
Probably bored.
Alright, once you enter, the walls of this 20-foot-high pillared chambers are adorned with frescoes of bathing royalty. Natural light streams through the stained glass windows, creating a colorful pattern on the tiles of polished blue marble that cover the floor. Three shallow, sunken pools containing perfume, scented water, white marble bleaches bearing stacks of dry towels are situated near the pools, each of which come equipped with a pair of brass faucets.
Cool. Do the three humanoids see us?
Oh yeah, they look up and they see you, and then it's like walking into a tanning salon, I guess.
Hey.
So I'm gonna look around. And I thought I'd see this. So do I see the two doors or any other doors?
Yeah, when you walk in toward the back, you see the one bathhouse. You see a door to the right and a door to the left.
I'm going to go to the door to the right and just open it.
All right. So you're going to the D4?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. You don't see nothing. This room is furnished with fashions of massage table. You see draped in clean towels. You see bottles of perfume stored under the table. They look like they may be used to scent the pools, maybe. That's about it. Give me a perception when you get in there.
Let me get it. Jeez, an 8. It's a bad night.
Well, all of a sudden, you just happen to catch somebody bending over, and they kind of stood up. Welcome. I'm Jabaz. I am your masseuse. Are you my 12 o'clock?
No, sir.
You are here early. What? What can I do for you?
We heard of some rumblings down in the basement. We heard there's some stuff going on around here.
Basement? What basement? There's no basement.
We were told there's some shenanigans going on around here.
I don't know what you're talking about, good sir. Are you here for a massage or not?
No. If you could just point us to the basement.
There is no basement.
What was that lady's name that sent us down here?
Tarina. Hold on. What the hell is that kid doing tearing up my shit?
Which one?
One of the kids, Sarah's watching. Watch, they're all out front yard, ripping up my shrubs. We're trying to. Never mind. Carry on.
So Trina said that there's been a lot of bad stuff going on around here, and she said she's heard that it's coming from the basement.
I don't know who Trina is, sir. There is no basement.
Well, you don't mind if I just look, check around the bathhouse?
Be my guest.
So I'm going to go ahead and go in the other door there.
Where are you going?
To the other door, that last door. D3, I guess.
D3, okay.
I'm assuming I was in D4.
Yeah. So you go into D3. You just walk in the door?
Sure.
Okay. D3 looks like an exact duplicate of D4. Except for Jabaz is not in there.
I'm going to check that room also, and I ain't doing any shit.
You don't see anything.
You want me to
come in behind you and try to check it? Sure, I'm gonna check it. So I'll just come in behind him and I'll do the
perception check.
Jabaz comes walking out of D4 and goes into the main D2 area and kind of goes over and starts talking to somebody. And he's pouring perfume into the pool of water.
I got a 12, it looks like.
Okay, what are you doing?
I'm trying to look around to see if there's anything to help us figure out the doorway to the basement.
And which room?
D4. We're in D4.
Chris went into D3, but D4, you think you see in the very top corner a crack. You're not sure. Something does not look right. The very top corner of D4.
Okay, so we need to investigate that. So
okay.
So I would roll an investigation?
No.
Is anybody?
You can walk up to it, take a look at it, and do another perception.
Okay. Can I? Okay. What'd you say? Do another perception?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I'm going to walk up to it. I'm going to do another perception roll and see if I can see anything. Good. I got a 10.
Okay. You apply a little bit of pressure on the wall and it seems to open up. And now you see this.
Okay, so it's starting to open up. So I say to my fellow people, hey, you guys, like, I think I found a way in. You guys want to come check this out?
I lead the way.
All right.
Yeah, we did go in.
Okay, so everybody's there with me now. So can we get the door open? Can we, like, pull on it, push on it? What do we have to do? Right, maybe pull or push to try to get it to give?
Push.
We have to push. Okay, so we have to do a roll for that too, right?
No, you just tell me you're going to push on the wall or whatever you're going to do. Just let me know what you're doing.
So I'm going to push on the wall and see if it gives anymore.
It does.
Okay, cool. So how much does it give? Do we need to give it some more pushing?
It's obviously a door.
Obviously. Okay, guys, so let's get this door open.
It's open.
All right, awesome. So what do we see? Perception?
No, you see stairs leading down. Okay. As you see in the picture I threw up. Okay. See the picture?
Before I go down in there, I'm going to run back, and I'm going to kick that guy in the nards. And tell him
he's not in the room.
He's not in D2 anymore?
No, he's in D2, yeah.
So yeah, I'm gonna go do it.
You can go kick the guy in the nuts?
Yeah. And tell him he that's for lying to me.
Well, maybe he didn't know.
D3 whenever you were talking to him, right? Or were you in D4?
D4.
And he lied to you.
What makes you think he lied to you?
He may not know, Chris.
This is his place. I'd do it anyways.
That's not his place.
Don't be kicking people in the nut and causing problems. Let's go down them stairs.
I don't see any problem, Chris, going in and like, kicking his nut. So just go do it, Chris.
What you do?
My character's a little... It doesn't play crap.
Oh, okay.
So I'm going to go do that, and then I'm going to go back forth to y'all.
So you're going to go kick this guy?
Yeah.
All right, hold on.
Good God. Right. I mean, I can't take him nowhere.
I'm playing a different character this time. Somebody that's not so honorable.
I don't mind going down the stairs first. I'm like, is there light down these stairs? Can you see down them or is it dark?
Hold on. My screen just went dark.
So it's dark.
That's what I was thinking too.
All right, let's see. All right. So what are you going to do?
That's what I'm asking. Is it dark in the staircase or is it light?
Oh, it's dark.
Okay.
I'm still trying to figure out what Chris is doing. Let's go back to Chris.
He said he went and kicked him in the nuts and came back.
Well, no, that's not how that works.
Yeah, that's supposed to be. I'm going to go.
Get out of the nuts. Consequences.
Exactly.
Hey, listen, he said he was going to do it. I just went with it.
All right, hold on. I'm not liking that.
Chris.
Alright.
Do you have things that, where is it at?
What's what?
Do halflings, they got dark vision or no?
Halfling? No.
Dark vision?
Yes. You have dark vision? Are you playing a gnome or halfling?
I'm a halfling. Like, halfling.
Where's that player's handbook at, man?
I'm looking through. I thought you usually shows it on your... I'm on D&D, so it usually shows it in there.
All right, well, roll to hit this guy.
Okay,
if you're going to kick him.
And D20 plus...
Great, my wife's walking up, spanking my daughter's hind end.
I got a 24 to hit. Plus a sneak attack bonus. Did I do a sneak attack? Are we doing, I'm not rolling for damage.
That wouldn't be a sneak attack. You walk up and kick him in the nuts. I mean...
I feel like it would have been a sneak attack. He doesn't know it's coming. He doesn't know it's coming.
How do you know he doesn't know it's coming? I mean, using her, giving him a hard time, and all of a sudden you come out of the room, swinging your leg in his groin area. He doesn't see it coming. You hit. So roll for damage.
Oh, okay, sweet. Okay. I guess unarmed strike. 1d10. Bludgeoning damage. I'm guessing it's only one. Yeah, it's only one hit point of damage. Bludgeoning damage.
What are you doing?
It just says bludgeoning damage one. It doesn't say a D, whatever. I guess maybe because I'm a halfling, I can only deliver one hit point of bludgeoning damage.
So what are you doing though? You're just kicking?
Yeah, just kicking.
So unarmed strike?
Yes, it's unarmed strike. Plus two to hit. And then extra says damage, just one. I don't say 1d4, 1d3, nothing. Just says one.
Okay, so you kick him in the nuts and takes 1 point of nut damage.
I didn't expect this one hit point, but...
Lord have mercy. What did you expect?
I guess he's going to strike back. So, I guess after he strikes back, y'all can roll for niche if you want, who all is going to be involved.
I think he got himself into this.
Alright.
I'm just like... I just don't go around kicking people in the nuts.
Plus, it's... One plus strength modifier. So it's one. Okay. One damage.
Okay.
What did you roll?
14.
14, that's a miss.
Okay.
Feels good.
He tries to kick you back, I guess.
And I tell him that's for lying to me about the doorway.
He asked you what doorway? He has no idea what you're talking about.
Well, you should have knew about the doorway in your corner room that you just came out of.
Well, he doesn't know nothing. What you're talking about? All he knows is that you attacked him. He blows a whistle, and four guards come in.
Oh, now we gotta come and help your ass.
Okay.
All right.
Let's do it.
So all right, roll for Nish.
So I go over to where the commotion's coming from, away from the staircase. And I see him. all excited giggling because he kicked somebody in the nut.
Now, you all don't have to jump in, but you all can. I mean, it's up to you. There's five guards.
I'm there. I'll back you up. Just because you wanted to be a butthole.
I mean, can we settle this peacefully? Be like, hey, he didn't mean it.
He laughed, but they know.
So, after he blows his whistle, in comes to the front door are five guards. They're wearing chainmail shirts. They got shields. And they're carrying spears.
Oh, yay. Okay.
Thank you, man.
All for one, one for all, bro.
Wait, if I disengage, would they, does he get an unarmed, does he get a strike pet?
Who?
The guy that blew the whistle?
He's not one going to be fighting. You kicked him in the balls, he reacted, and then he missed and he blew his whistle. He's done. He's not involved in this fight. Guards are taking over. Now, and these are the city watch.
We have,
we haven't helped
city watch yet. So are they coming in to attack, or what are they doing?
They're coming in to find out what's going on.
Oh, okay.
Hey, sorry guys, I'm not too much involved. I just received an email from the project lead and there's something need to be done. But okay. I'll be listening to you guys.
Sounds good.
So
it's all good.
We dash into the secret door and
I was gonna try and turn tail and run down the secret door and shut the door.
Okay.
Okay, well I guess I'm going back over there since I came to help him.
So what?
Staircase. And so, since it's dark down there, did you say that you had, what is your name, Amanda? Is that what it is? Did you say you have night vision?
Yeah, I have dark vision.
Okay. So.
You might want to take point.
Yeah, you might want to go down first since you can see.
Alrighty, I'll start going down first. And.
Alright.
Okay.
Ground.
Let me pull this up.
I don't mind going, do you want me to go last, Chris, or you want me to go second?
I go second.
Okay, I'll go last. Is that what you're doing? You're 1 second, right?
Yeah, you can go second. I go last. It's fine. It don't matter.
Whichever way you want, I don't care.
I go last. I got a crossbow.
I will come with you guys.
Okay. All right, here comes Furs. He's thinking, crazy son of a bitch kicked him in the balls.
one hit point of damage. I thought it'd be like a 1D, 2D3 or D4 or whatever.
This mouse is messing up. I don't know what's going on. The ones that Sam thought we needed.
I haven't had an issue with it. Are you running Bluetooth?
It's wireless.
Oh, I got mine wired.
You got it run wired?
Yeah. I'll
probably have to do the same then.
I run mine wired to that, docking station.
All right, Amanda, this is what you see. You descend down some stairs. You find yourself in room D5. D5 is covered in water. The dungeon's room, you find yourself down in the dungeon. The rooms, corridors, and staircases are hewn from limestone, and until it's dark. So unless you have any way of seeing,
how high is the water?
5 foot. No, I'm sorry, 2 foot. The corridor is 5 foot wide.
That's hey, Tab, you got dark vision, by the way.
Do I?
Yeah, dwarves have dark vision.
Well, I wasn't a dwarf last time. I'm a halfling, so I'm still looking through my stuff.
Either way, halflings still have dark vision, but we're good.
Where do I find that at, Mike?
Give me, when you enter, are you going in the room?
Yeah.
Give me a dexterity saving throw.
Ooh.
Who's all in the room?
Me,
Rolling down it.
Yep. All right. Everybody roll for a dex save.
What is the dex? Let's see.
Got a
19. Oh, that's not mine.
All right, Kayla, you make it.
Okay.
I got an 8.
Cool. Amanda, you did not make it.
Well, shoot.
Oh, I got 3 roll.
Oh, okay.
I got lucky. 14, right?
You did not make it. DC is 15.
Damn it.
You guys that do not make it.
What was that? What was I rolling for?
A dex save.
Oh, I got a 15. I got a +4, not a +3. So that's 15 even. Does it meet it? Beats?
It does meet.
Can
it
I
meet.
Try to?
Yes, sir, if you're there.
So what's the modifier? Dexterity?
Yep.
Dex, yeah.
Okay, it's +3.
Okay, 22. Woo!
All right, you make it. Whoever did not roll a 15, you will take 5 bludgeoning damage as the roof collapses behind you and seals off the exit, or the entrance, actually.
Does a 15 meet? Or no?
Meet or beat, correct.
Okay. So I'm good.
Yep.
Okay.
So whoever did not make it, you take bludgeoning damage. 5 points.
Okay, so is it still dark down here?
Yep.
Okay.
We even got darker. As a light behind you.
Apparently, I have dark vision too. So, and I can see shades of gray up to 60 feet. That's what it says.
You can see the whole room.
Yeah, I was going to say, can I look around? Is there, what do
yeah.
I see?
You see 2 foot of water. You see wooden beams that kind of go across the ceiling. You see where it had collapsed behind you. Rotten wood has been rotten.
Mm-hmm. Do I see any other like tunnels or anything where we can go, or other room doors where we can go into?
The picture is in the room in the text.
I'm looking. Sorry, I'm still learning where the stuff's at.
No, you're good.
Okay, it's a D5, right?
Right.
Okay. So my thought process would be that over in that corner where it kind of ends is probably where they're hiding.
Yeah, I don't know if anybody's in there. I don't think anybody's in there, but I say we check it.
Yeah, we should definitely check it. What do you other guys think?
Yeah,
let's scope it out.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. I don't mind going first.
So you guys go down the very bottom right or left-hand corner?
Yep.
Okay. Yep.
Okay. It's pretty much the same thing that you see, water covers the floor, about 2 foot deep. When you get to the end, roll me a perception.
Okay.
'Cause
somebody's gonna have to look at it for me.
I got 20
rounds. Yep. Boom. You noticed a crack in the door or in the wall, and you think it's a secret door.
Okay.
So I call over, I say, everybody else, hey man, it looks like there's something beyond this wall here. Does anybody got some good strength to potentially push open that wall?
So you're looking for somebody with good strength?
Yeah, because okay. I got a 0 on strength.
My strength is a 6. you want me to roll?
Yeah. I push it open.
Got it. Roll 21.
Okay. It opens up very easily.
Okay. So what do we see now that it's opened up? Can we see anything?
I'm getting there.
Okay.
There you go. That's what you see.
Awesome. Oh. Okay. So the S is what, stairs?
Secret door.
No, it's a secret door.
Okay. So we see that. All right. So should we... I think we should continue forward and maybe, like, go into room D6. What do y'all think?
Yeah, we should.
Yeah.
We should go to D6.
All right, D6. As you enter the room, you see face down in the middle, the room is flooded. You see bloated corpse.
Ew.
Of a shirtless male human with a knife wound in his back.
Okay. All right.
I'm gonna search that body.
The shirtless body?
Search the body.
Okay. How do you search them? Do you roll them over? Explain what you're doing.
I am going to. Is he wearing clothes or anything? Is this?
He's shirtless.
Well, pants.
He's got pants on.
So.
I hate to ask why, but hey.
Yeah. So I'm going, actually, I'm going to take my rapier out,
okay.
And I'm going to poke it.
You're going to poke it? All
poke
right.
The body first, make sure it's not some kind of stupid zombie or something.
It doesn't move.
Doesn't move?
Mm-mm.
Okay. Well, I'm going to go ahead and check the pockets and stuff.
They're empty. Body.
Empty, nothing?
Nothing.
There's nothing on the dude.
Nada.
So I noticed I'm assuming rubble in one corner of D6.
Okay.
Check that.
Okay. There's nothing.
Nothing. Oh, I wasted my 20, thank you.
Can you tell how recently he died?
You can do a medicine check on him. Anybody got medicine?
I'm gonna plus 2 in medicine. Imagine that.
Okay.
I have plus 4.
Go for
there
it,
you
buddy.
Go.
So we roll in D20?
Yep. Add 4.
1D20 plus 4.
That's enough. You can tell the corpse was once a worshiper of Baal. Other than that, looks like he's been dead for a while. And looks like he might have been killed by a cultist because of the knife. Sticking in his back is known as a knife that's carried by the cultist.
Oh, I thought it was just that one.
No, that was a knife in his back. Huh?
The knife is still there?
Yeah.
I'm gonna pull that knife out.
Alright.
And just regular knife?
Just regular knife. Yep.
I'm not gonna need that. I'm gonna throw it away.
Okay.
Unless somebody wants a knife. Until we move on past D6.
Alright, so where are you going now?
To the right
of D6?
Right of D6, correct.
Okay. This mouse is messing up. I just charged it too. I know it's not that. Alright, see if I can. I'm trying to copy this without giving away too much. Alright, that'll work.
Did you have this module, or did you just buy it?
This? No, yeah. I bought it for our Saturday night game.
Okay. So, who's taking point in D7? Who's taking point in D7?
So you guys moving in?
Yeah, I can go ahead and check it out.
Okay.
Go for it.
As you walked into D7, three wooden beams brace the ceiling of this flooded chamber, which features a stone altar covered with the entrails in the northwest corner. Hanging on the wall above the altar is a 3-foot-tall steel mask cast in the form of a frowning human skull.
Is that it?
That's it. Basically, it looks like some sort of an altar. And there seems to be some sort of offering of entrails. Roll me a history, somebody.
What?
History check?
Yeah, mine is just plus one.
I got a plus zero, so.
Okay, go ahead and.
I got a plus zero, so.
That's 11.
What you got?
I got 11.
11! You know from the looks of things and the altar, you recognize the altar is for the god of murder, which is Baal. You think if you have any vials of holy water, you think possibly if you pour it on the entrails, they might do something.
Okay. Should we go ahead?
A druid will probably have some holy water somewhere, I would think. We'll say he
holy
does.
Water.
It should be part of a starter kit, don't it?
Nah, it's more of a cleric, but I'm just kind of giving it to him.
Oh.
You guys don't have a cleric?
He bless water and make it holy water?
Absolutely. You could sneeze on it, somebody could say bless you, and it's blessed.
There you go.
I'll be here all week, folks.
So, does anybody have holy water? No, or just
I just say I found some holy water. I don't think I have even holy water.
Okay.
Do I see any holy water around the altar?
No.
Oh.
That's alright. Basically, pouring holy water would make the entrails disappear, melt them, and then the altar would smolder. That's all. Nothing big. Alright. Moving on. What do you guys do?
Is there anything else within the room?
Nope.
Any significance behind the pillars? No.
Nope.
I said we go down E7.
Yeah.
Okay. And this is what you see. There you go. I cut it off, but that's D8. That's weird.
Is that like a wall right there?
Yeah, if you click on it, it opens up. I don't know why the... Oh, okay, you can scroll. Oh, never mind. It looked like I cut it off, but it's not. It's just it wouldn't scroll down all the way.
Alright. So it's just a wall.
Dang it. Can we see what's in D8?
Absolutely. So you walk in the room D8. What you see here is a wall. Seems to be some sort of a tapestry, and it's moldy. It's about 5 foot by 7 foot. If you look closely, it looks like it has a picture that dictates a grisly scene of four faceless figures ripping apart a fifth figure. And it looks like the fifth figure is screaming.
Super weird.
This place is great, guys.
Yeah, I know, man.
You said that was a wall right there, right? It doesn't go any further to the left or right.
Can we check what's behind it? Like, it looks like there's a gap between that wall and the end. Is it?
That's the tapestry. Mm-hmm. So do you look behind it?
Yeah, let's see what's behind it.
All right. Oh, nice.
Rodney, if you're talking, I can't hear you.
When you touched it, you noticed there was like this spores of yellow dust. And give me 1 second.
Do you get resistance to poisoning damage?
Yeah, pretty much.
That's what it sounds like.
Don't tell me that I'm dead.
No.
No, I think first, do you have resistance to poisoning damage?
Where do I find this?
Look up Wood Elf real quick.
No?
No, look up Wood Elf real quick. I don't think he has any.
Wood Elf.
Alright, we'll have to look this up. Good old Google.
So, according to,
screen keeps going black. I don't know what's going on.
Was it, I mean, to measure
the default on the laptop, too?
There's an ad. Hi!
It says Wood Elves apparently are even immune to the poison status effect.
Alright. So you take no damage, but you figured out that it's poisonous. It's yellow mold.
Okay, guys, do not touch anywhere. It seems like it's covered with the poison. Just warning you.
I say get the hell out of here.
Yeah, let's get the hell out of here.
Alright, moving on. Good choice.
Elwood, you want to take point on the next room?
See, my screen keeps going black. I don't know what's going on. It's with Google or Chrome.
Sure. Let's proceed on.
Proceed. Alright. So you guys find a set of stairs to the left or to the right, however you're standing, and as you descend from the stairs, the ground becomes dry. Okay, and you're leaving D7, D8 area, and this is what you see. Well, shnikes, that's not gonna help. That'll work. And that's what you see. D9. Not denied, but D9. When you guys enter this chamber, it is empty, but not brief, or not brief of decor. Carved into each of these three doors is a figure dictating one of the dead three. Somebody roll me an intelligence check or religion if you have it.
Ha! Not here.
Takes that coffee and made a whole pot's worth of coffee in the French press to make one cup.
Perfect.
What?
Taste it. I ground up enough coffee beans and did a French press. It only made one cup.
Wow.
Pretty strong, huh?
It is.
I'll be up all night.
Good.
So did you guys roll?
Yeah, first at 22.
22! Ding, 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 ding. We have a winner. Chicken dinner. All right. Your intelligence check has seen you dictate on the east door. There's a face on this door that bears a carving of Bane, the lawful evil god of tyranny, who is dictating a tall, armored man wearing a bucket helm. His right gauntlet is painted black and clutches a set of shackles. On the north door, this door bears a carving of Baal, the chaotic evil god of murder. He is dictating as a powerful built, skull-headed man with long curved blades where his hands should be. The south door. This door is bearing a carving of Merkel, the natural evil lord of bones. He is portrayed as a cloaked figure whose face is hidden under a cowl. In his skeletal hands, he clutches a screaming human skull. Well, ladies and gentlemen, what room would you like to go into?
All those doors sound terrible.
Yes, they do. And it sure ain't Monty Python either. Or Monty Hall, I'm sorry. Door number one. Door number two is probably older than you guys. Let's make a deal. I think it's what it was called.
I'll let you go ahead and pick which one you want to go to since you're taking point in this room. I imagine eventually we're all going to have to go through one of the doors eventually. All of them.
You don't have to, but...
All right, which one was the... What was his name? The one with the... Had the altar?
That was, Baal.
I will go through Baal's door.
Baal's door. All right. Which will be the... North door.
Maybe that one will loop back
around. North door loops back around into D5. So you guys find yourself in the D5.
So we'll go back. And then we're going to put either the east or south wall.
Hold on, guys. My wife's talking. Do what? Where the kids?
Perhaps you need to go back to the south, please.
Hold on.
Which one are we going to go into?
Hold on a second.
Okay.
They went with Megan over to Mercy's house to go swimming.
Okay, when are they coming back?
We'll be back probably by 8 o'clock or so, a little bit after. If you're going to be up all night.
I'm not being up all night.
You just said you drink coffee.
Great.
If you don't want to, do you care if the kids and I go, but we're gonna might go to Margarita House?
8 o'clock and what?
They're open till 10.
What makes you think I don't wanna go?
That's what I just said.
You didn't say that.
I said if you don't wanna go, do you care if the kids and I wanna go?
How you like that punchline?
Normally you say no.
I don't know, we'll talk about it later, okay?
Yep.
Alright. Alright, be careful. Alright. So, what do you guys do?
I would put her. Yeah, first I would pick a door. I let y'all pick.
Yeah, we can.
East door. Okay. The east door has a face of Bane. So you guys open up the east door, and this is what you see. Ah. Exposing too much. A long tunnel.
Are those little lines, those stairs going up or down?
They're going down.
Down. Okay, so we're going further. Keep going further down, down, down.
Well, you guys just came up from D8. D8 to D9 was...
Okay, yeah.
Now you're going back down. Up.
So anytime we go down, we're going in water. So we're going further down to the water.
Okay.
I'm gonna go towards that water and is there anything? Is when I get to that water, is it the same kind of water as the rest of the place we've been through?
Yep, it's wet.
Yeah. Okay. I didn't know if we had any kind of worse smell or anything.
It smells wet.
All right, plunge all in there and go to that into whatever room that is.
Okay. Does everybody follow?
I can't.
Yeah, I'll go with.
I'm sorry.
We're not gonna let him die.
Captain
Obvious. In that shithole.
I gotta find somebody else to kick.
Oh my goodness gracious.
All right, here we go. Damn it. I'm about to kick my monitor. There we go.
Ronnie, I feel like you're Howard Stern over there. You got your own talk show with that mic and that light. I did, really do.
D12. Sweet. All right, this is Bane's altar.
All right.
Now you guys just kind of tromped in there. So this eastern part of the room is unlit. It's flooded and braced with floor-to-ceiling wooden beams. Rough-hewn steps rise out of the murky water to the western portion of the room, which is dry and lit by two torches and scrones that flank a stone altar. Shackled to the wall behind the altar is a sickly man in loincloth and a burlap sack over his head. An alcove to the north of the wall contains a freestanding suit of plate armor missing its helm. Standing before the altar are two grim figures, a powerful built woman clutching a mace, an even bigger man wearing a bucket helm. The helmed man is jabbing the prisoner with a spear, causing him to twitch. Both figures are clad in chainmail, and the woman carries a wooden shield with a leering skull painted on it. And they turn to look at you. Roll for Nish.
Okay. So the altar is in the back. There.
Yeah.
What are the little squares,
right? Little squares,
what were they again?
God, that sucked. How does that happen?
What are we rolling?
Initiative. It's on.
I got 19, Ron.
On.
I went over to get food again, sorry.
22.
Where the hell do I find that?
I got 15.
It's one of your pluses. Whenever you do an action, your attack, it's what? You got probably plus 6?
No, I don't. If I'm looking at it correctly, INT, is that it?
No, before your hit's at. Because it gives you all your...
Yeah, my bad. I have
21. Alright, so...
How did I get the worst? Second worst.
every time somebody posts, it pops up in the right-hand corner. Is there a way to make that stop? Because it throws my computer.
If you right-click on that little notice stuff,
uh-huh.
You can get it going in the app settings, and it says right-click on it, says don't show app icons, or don't show number of notifications. You may have to open it. And
all right, these are the mobs. I'm going to roll their initiative here.
Do you hear me,
Chris? Do
what? That's what you work on this weekend for me?
Yep.
Okay, that's one. And mob number one. This is mob number two. Alright. So what did everybody get?
I got 21.
I got 15.
I got 22.
Okay, so 22 is the highest so far, I believe, right?
Yeah.
Yep.
And that is Eliwick.
Yep. I have a short bow, but we have to have arrows, or are we assuming we have arrows?
You have arrows.
All right, and I'm gonna take my short bow.
Okay, hold on 1 second. I'm still trying to get initiative order. Furs, you got a 15. Kayla got a 21.
Yeah.
All right, Kayla, roll d6. All right. Got to beat a 4.
D6 plus 6.
Huh?
Nothing.
I roll my D6 plus my weapon, right?
No, just D6. D6. We're trying to figure out initiative order.
Okay.
So this is mob 1. Okay, then 21 is going to go Kayla. And you're playing a dwarf what?
Barbarian.
Okay.
You know barbarians, right? I mean, what was I last time? A halfling barbarian.
I got an 18, which is mob number 2. Okay. First got a 17, no, 15, right?
I got 15.
Okay. Okay, who's after Furs? What'd you get?
I got 19, right?
You got 19?
Yeah, I'm like fourth.
Okay, what are you playing?
Halfling, that's right. Rogue. Assassin Rogue. Eventually assassin, but...
Alright. And what'd you get, Amanda?
22.
That's right, you're going first. Okay, so who am I missing? That's everybody, right?
Uh-huh.
You get me 2 mobsters?
Yeah, they're in here. Okay.
Yep.
Alright. Now you can go, Eliwick.
All right, I'm gonna do a short bow, and I'm gonna go for the woman.
Going for the woman. She is mob number 1.
All right.
Does she have to attack him first?
What?
Does she also attack him first?
Eliwick is going first.
No, I mean first in the mob.
Yeah. Far as you know.
Modifier do I use again?
Your bow. So it'll be dex.
So you got a short bow, it'll be a 1d6 plus whatever your dexterity is.
No, it'll be a 1d20.
Oh, yeah. 1d20 plus whatever modifier is. Dex plus.
That will hit.
That's a 1d6 plus what?
Whatever your modifier is. It should tell you in your sheet. No?
Did you fill out a sheet in hand, or did you do it online?
Did it online.
So are you on D&D Beyond?
No, I haven't updated.
Oh.
Oh.
Did you level up?
I did.
Should be like 1d6 plus probably for damage 1d6.
What's your dex? You should have a high dex. Should be a plus 4, I think.
Yeah.
So roll 1d6 plus 4.
Yep.
8 damage. Okay.
Solid.
All right. She's up next. She's going to charge in, and what was the marching order?
I'm after her.
What was the marching order when you guys came in the room? I think Cannabis was leading, right? So this is going to be against you, sir.
Is that me, right?
Yep, because you're the first one in the room, yeah. Right?
Yeah.
Okay.
I know where they're going.
So she's coming after you. She's got an arrow stuck in her, but she's got this skull flail out, and she's coming after you. She's screaming in Celestial. Hurrah! Is it 13?
Yes.
Okay, that will resolve her turn. Make sure she got one. Okay. All right. Then the next up will be Kayla.
I'm happy to look at form real quick. Without being
do what?
I need him to look at my form. Because I think I have double-handed weapon, do I not?
Yeah, you should have.
I got a double-handed battle axe with armaded discs, I guess it's a.
It's got two handles on it?
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
And a sissy bar?
Yeah, battle axe. You got a battle axe.
How do I
nobody caught that.
1d20 plus 6.
If you hit, it's a d12,
okay,
right?
Okay, I want to make sure. Okay. So I'm going to try to hit the one with my battle axe because we already started there.
Okay.
And
not
an
11. That will hit.
And then I do a
1d10 plus 4 because we're doing two-handed.
Okay, so that's what I was going to ask you. Okay, I've never had two-handed. One. Okay. 6.
Okay.
That's what I was wondering. If I just did one hand, then it would be the other one, correct?
Yeah.
Cannabis, you're up.
I guess just you take a swing at me. I'm gonna pull up my rapier and I'm trying and slash her across her face. Jeez, man. What is lucky? Is lucky a 1 or a 2, right? Or is it just 1?
1.
Ah, man. That's just horrible. Just not doing it today, man. I missed. Okay. I did it too.
All right. Mop 2 is up. It's the dude. He's coming in. He's going to probably swing at you as well.
The dude?
The dude. All right. And he misses. Next up is Furs.
Damn, d20 plus 5.
Okay. So what was the, do we add the initiative on d20?
No, your modifier. What are you doing?
I'm gonna grab my longsword with two hand. I'm gonna rush at him, try to slice him open. Just
okay.
Yeah. So the hit. Okay. So the hit point is plus four. So I should I just get plus four?
What you're gonna do is you're gonna come in, and you're gonna roll a d20 plus four.
Uh-huh.
You're gonna add four to it.
Yeah. All right. Come on, please hit it. Yeah, I think that's a hit.
Yeah, which one are you hitting?
So, since I'm using two hands, should I roll twice?
No. Which one are you hitting? The man or the woman?
I think I can just hit the man since we already have some damage on woman.
Okay.
Yeah, we can just go ahead. I can just go ahead and point to the man.
Okay, roll 1d10 plus 2. And that'll be your damage.
Come on. Oops.
Alright.
Oh my god. Four hit points.
Okay.
Wah, wah.
Wah, wah, wah.
Top of the round. Eliwick.
Alright, same thing. I'm gonna do a bow. It's the woman.
Okay.
Just out of curiosity, are we flanking this lady?
Are you? She's doing the bow.
One's in front of me, or she's next to me, and also Tab's right there, too.
All right, nobody said they're flanking, get behind or anything, so I don't know what response I'm asking you guys.
Anytime we get in attack mode, guys, if one person's already attacking somebody hand-to-hand, or space-to-space, say you're getting into a flanking mode, that way you have advantage on your rolls.
All right.
So we'll go for it.
So you can five foot step around, get into flanking.
Can you flank with a bow?
No, then you said there's a barbarian there too?
Yeah.
And then there's also a druid that's swinging a melee weapon.
Me and the barbarian are meleeing against the first foe.
Okay. So do you move into flanking?
Yes.
Okay.
So you got flanking advantage there, Elwood.
All right, I'm not really sure what that does for my roll. I mean, I rolled an 11, but...
You hit.
Alrighty.
It gives you a second roll, so if you miss the first time, you can roll a second time. So I would say go ahead and roll again, just to get a critical d20, and then you get max damage. So always roll twice.
Hey, guys, I'm going to turn the AC on. Give me one moment.
Gotcha.
I'll be right back.
So you hit and just roll for your normal damage.
All right.
I'm on mute for a sec.
Mob one is dead. Describe how you killed her.
Didn't she have a skull thing on her?
Yep. Shield.
What was that?
It was a shield.
Oh okay.
She had a sorry. Yeah, she had just had a wooden shield that had a skull that was painted on it.
All right, well, I shoot her my bow, and I know it's over, and then I run up to her, and I take her shield.
Uh-huh.
I finish the job and hit her over the head with it.
All right. Mob 1 is up, but she's dead, so she's down. Kayla. Excuse me.
Sorry, I was yelling at my kids. All right, so the second one's the guy, right?
Yeah.
So, is anybody standing over by him already or no? Was everybody flanking the other one?
No, well, Furs is over there fighting him.
Hurt?
So if you want to get into flanking.
I'll go over there and join him.
Okay.
Do I need to go behind him or something?
If you want to, that's flanking.
I can flank, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
All right, and then I just roll my a d20, right?
D20 plus your bonus.
I got it. It was 6, I think. Yep. Got an 11.
Yep, that hits.
Do it again.
The D20 plus 6?
Yeah, do that twice. Just in case you get a crit.
I didn't do. Hold on.
You do? Or you don't?
Apparently. Hold on. That's what happened to the sunflower seed. So it's okay. I got a 20.
Ah, okay.
Womp, womp, womp.
So roll your damage.
Okay. And that is a 1, 8, 10.
Welcome back. Welcome back. You cooler?
Yeah. I didn't know that my roommate just turned. Why did he turn off the AC? It was just like really hot in here. Yeah, is this my turn?
10 damage, right?
Not yet.
Alright, next up is Cannabis.
I'm gonna pull out my keep my Reaper out, and I'm gonna run up, and since everybody's already flanking, I'm going to attack them and stab at them. I'm gonna use the first one for the damage. Damn, I got 12 points. So just 10 damage.
Okay. And describe how you killed him.
So I ran up, jumped in the air, and lunged at him with my rapier right through his neck. And as I, my force of my body hits him and he falls backwards, landing on the sarcophagi. Yes. Thank you, sir.
Okay, fight is now over. The gentleman is standing at the altar still. What do you guys do?
I'm gonna loot the bodies first.
You're gonna loot the body? Forget the guy that's standing there with wounds on him?
I'm a rogue assassin. I'm worried about my money and my pay first.
Alright. Alright, you guys find the wooden shield that Eliwick has in her hands. Basically, you find a bucket helm, a mace, and that's about it. Two maces, actually.
That's it.
Mm-hmm. So do you go check out the prisoner?
Yeah, we're gonna go talk to him first. See why he's all chained up.
All right. He just tells you that he was captured in the lower city of Boulder's Gate. He's not sure what's going on. This happened about 2 days ago. His bodyguards were slain. He tells you that he is a He's barely clinging on to life, for one. He seems to be some sort of a merchant, perhaps. He tells you that his family, who lives in the upper part of the city, will more than likely pay handsomely for his reward if you bring him back to safety.
Okay.
Someone heal him?
Are we going to need to heal him and let him go, or?
He's got one hit point. It's up to you guys. You guys take him back and rescue him and try to seek reward, or you just kind of heal him and let him go? It's up to you. Or not even heal him at all.
It's going to probably, we'll probably be down here for a while, maybe. We don't know how long we'll be down here. After we get his information, and maybe collect the reward later.
Well, you have to get him out of the dungeon.
After we just let him go back. Did we want to let him get him out of the dungeon? But the passageway that we came in is blocked, so he's just gonna have to come with us, huh?
It's up to you guys. Bum, bum, bum.
Yeah,
we can
do that. I mean, I'm fine with it.
I said we just heal him, and if he wants to tag along, he can tag along. If not, we...
Okay.
Look.
Sounds good to me.
All right, so he's going to tag along with you guys. We'll end it here. I'm going to go have dinner with my family. So we'll pick up next week in room D12, correct?
That sounds good.
Alright.
Thank you, Rodney.
Thank you, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Hope you had fun.
Yeah, it was fun. Thank you so much.
Hopefully Rodney, our...
Everyone else.
I was in level 2, right?
Yeah, you guys level 2.
We're going to stay at this for a while.
I'm sorry?
How long are we going to stay at level 2? Just out of curiosity, probably.
Until you guys level up level 3.
I need that third level, man. I can't wait to be that rogue assassin. Sweet.
All right. All right, I'll see you guys later.
Bye.
Bye.
See you guys. Bye.
Thanks again.
Bye.
Thank you.
Oh, get out of here, Rodney.